As a child, Brandon was in love with his classmate Rose. They were neighbors and went to school together. And often spent time with each other. They even decided to go to the same university after graduation. According to the results of the exams, the boy did not get into the university, but Rose got in. Brandon had to go to study at another university in another city. They did not manage to meet as often as before and they became distant. Soon Rose began to change boyfriends one by one. One of them worked as a programmer, and after a while they got married. Brandon silently moved on, and then he got to know Molly. He fell in love with her not immediately, but he was soon enchanted by her kindness and loyalty. Molly was not a beauty, but after the wedding she became prettier, and a few years later she gave him a daughter, who was named Mia. Besides, as a wife she was just perfect. She cooked very well, and her home was always clean and comfortable. Only the relationship with her mother-in-law did not work out. Brandon's mother grumbled that they were not a couple. She wanted a prettier and less domestic wife for her son. But after the birth of her granddaughter, they reconciled and mother-in-law realized that her son was very happy with his family life. Brandon had a brilliant career, going from managing director to head of a company. The family lived in a beautiful house and often vacationed abroad. Brandon was glad that his relatives were doing well, especially since he had seen some of his friends' families fall apart, because of adultery or scandals or mutual resentment. Brandon's home has always been a source of strength. From every business trip, he longed for his family and missed his girls. When Brandon looked at Molly, he knew in his heart that she was the person he wanted to meet old age with. But after such a long family idyll, life prepared a surprise for Brandon, deciding to test his strength. It began with an unplanned trip to a business partner on the other side of the country. On one of the days of this business trip, his partner was hosting a dinner party at his home and invited Brandon. Among invited guests was a beautiful woman, who immediately attracted Brandon's attention and seemed familiar to him. He recognized Rose with great surprise. She had been a beautiful woman before, but now she was simply dazzling. Rose also recognized him and was very happy. They spent the entire evening talking about childhood and life in general. After her divorce from the programmer, Rose devoted herself to her career. She established herself as a businesswoman, and now she was the lead manager of his business partner. The man was excited to meet his first love and fascinated by her beauty. Rose was genuinely happy to meet him unexpectedly after all these years too. The next day she invited him to her house, and Brandon gladly accepted the invitation. The old feelings flared up, and the man looked at Rose with undisguised admiration. She also did not hide her passion. This night was magical. They enjoyed every minute spent together. A couple of days later, all the business and negotiations were over, and it was time to return. For the first time, Brandon did not want to go home, and his wife's voice even irritated him on the phone. At parting, Rose said that she planned to visit her mother in the near future. She lived in the same city where Brandon lived, so they would still have a chance to see each other. Brandon flew home. Although his wife and daughter were happy to see him back, he was far from them. All his thoughts were on Rose. At night, he even referred to fatigue and the difficult flight. But soon Brandon pulled himself together and tried to live as if nothing had happened. He immersed himself in work and somehow still returned to normal life. And then suddenly Rose flew in. She called and said that she was staying at her mother's house, who was now on vacation at the resort. Brandon immediately put everything aside and went to her. Once they were alone together, Brandon was happy again. From that moment, he regularly flew on business trips and met with Rose on various pretexts. Soon they both got tired of flying, and then Rose suggested Brandon to give her a job in his office, so they could see each other more often. He agreed. Since she worked in management for his partner, he took her on as his deputy so he could always be there for his beloved. Rose got to work. She quickly learned all the nuances and coped with the work very well. Brandon was pleased with her as the new deputy and the fact that they were now together. But because of his frequent absence from home, his wife became suspicious. Brandon heard reproaches more and more often, and she was constantly in a bad mood. He tried not to provoke scandals and carefully concealed the new relationship. A family celebration was planned for the near future. 15 years of Molly and Brandon's life together. The celebration was heartwarming. Many good words were said about the spouses. But Brandon felt remorse because he saw his wife's loving gaze and his daughter's happy eyes. He realized that he had betrayed them by continuing his relationship with Rose. But he had never felt such strong feelings for any woman. A sense of guilt tore the man. And after drinking heavily all evening, he became very intoxicated and fell asleep. Sometime later, he was scarcely woken up by his mother, who urgently needed to sign some documents. Brandon was insurmountably sleepy, so he left his signature on some paper without too many questions and went back to sleep. Only in several days he remembered about it and called his mother to specify what he had signed there. She answered that it had to do with her inheritance and it was nothing special. Brandon trusted the mother and quickly forgot about it. In the meantime, Rose was fed up with being number two and suggested her lover to divorce his wife. Brandon still delayed this difficult decision and could not make up his mind. Then Rose acted very wisely. She began to distance herself and avoid meeting him. And when she left on a business trip and did not answer her phone, Brandon panicked and referred to the urgent business and went to get her. They spent a few amazing days together. Exhausted by jealousy and blinded by passion, the man finally decided on a divorce. His mother was the first to know. Brandon remembered her passionate desire to marry him to Rose and hoped his mother would support him. But after listening to her son, she coldly said she was against breaking up the family. Not getting support from his mother, he went home with the intention of burning all bridges. Molly cried while her husband talked about his feelings for another woman. Then she screamed for him to get out of their house and out of her and their daughter's lives. It was painful to see her suffering. And he hurried to leave Molly. Rose tried to comfort Brandon and told him that all this would eventually be sorted out. But deep in Brandon's heart, there was pain from the betrayal of the family. The business distracted the man from his worries. And then he and Rose went on a small cruise on the Mediterranean Sea, where he proposed to her. It was decided to have the wedding as soon as the divorce papers were ready. After returning from the cruise, the lawyer told Brandon some unpleasant news. It turned out that he had transferred all of his real estate and all of his part of the business to his wife and daughter. When he checked the authenticity of the documents, he suddenly remembered that his mother had recently asked him to sign some papers and he had signed them. Shocked by what was happening, he immediately tried to contact his mother and then Molly. But they did not answer. The man helplessly appealed for help to the lawyers, but they just threw up their hands. The signature was authentic. And only if he went to court against his relatives, he could try to prove something. In the evening, Brandon told everything to Rose. She looked at all the papers, called somebody and said that his wife had robbed him completely. And that the only way to get back his fortune was through legal proceedings. If he agrees, then she will help him get every penny back. Brandon went to his mother to figure out why she had slipped him these papers. The woman met her son sternly, and then she told him that she had already lived many years and had seen a lot in her life. That's why she did it, to check on his Rose, and to find out whether she needed Brandon himself or his capital and company. Having quarreled with his mother, the man drove back to Rose. He knew very well that Rose was not with him for the money, and he decided to prove it to everybody. When he arrived, he told his beloved that he had thought everything over, and decided to leave everything to his wife and daughter, under such circumstances. And given their experience and abilities, he and Rose will create a joint business anew, and in 5 or 7 years everything will pay off. Rose was silent. Then she asked him to give her time to think it over, and in the meantime, to leave her alone. The next day, Brandon could not reach her. When he arrived at her house, her mother told him that Rose had gone away and left him a note. In the note, Rose apologized and said that she didn't want to waste her time starting all over again. She needed everything here and now. Brandon's world collapsed. The fire that had been raging in his heart was completely extinguished, and there was nothing left but dirty ashes. Devastated beyond belief, he went back to his mother's house, and Molly was there at the moment. The dear women looked at him, and for the first time in his life, Brandon cried. Molly and his mother, acting in tandem, decided to save not his business and finances at such a cost. They wanted to help save everything they held so dear, which was the family. After that meeting, Brandon lived alone for some time. He realized what a terrible mistake he had made, and decided to return Molly's love at all costs. The relationship with his wife and daughter was long and painstakingly restored. 3 years have passed and they are back together and happy again. The storm blew through, leaving devastation in its wake. But Brandon and Molly were still able to rebuild everything again. Dear friends, please write in the comments what you think about this story. Take care of yourselves and your loved ones, and see you soon.